A mischievous demon has captured you and a friend. He's always wanted a pet human, and now he has two. But before locking the cage, he decides to play a game. If you can beat him, he'll set you free. If not, you're doomed to live out your days counting hot and cold particles in a box. This is what he says. I will be waiting for you in a room with a deck of 52 cards, no jokers. Only you may enter. Your friend must wait outside. I will deal you 5 cards, which you can look at. You must choose 1 card and put it in your pocket. You must then place each of the remaining 4 cards in envelopes marked 1, 2, 3, and 4. And there is only room for 1 card in each envelope. You will exit the room and your friend will enter. By looking at the cards in the envelopes, he needs to guess which card is in your pocket. If he guesses correctly, you will both be set free. And don't even try using other signals, like folding or special placing of the envelopes. He gives the two of you 5 minutes to come up with a plan, and he's bugged the room and can hear everything you say. He's a very logical demon, and he can choose which 5 cards you get. If there is a flaw in your strategy, he will find it. Can you come up with a plan guaranteed to set you free? If the demon deals you 5 cards, then at least one of the suits must repeat. Remember, you can choose which card to put in your pocket, so you and your friend agree that you will choose a card with a repeated suit. You then place the other repeated card in the first envelope and use the remaining 3 envelopes to communicate which is the card in your pocket. Let's try with this hand. Diamonds is the repeated suit, so you can choose either the queen or the 4 of diamonds. But how do you decide which one? If we take any suit and choose 2 cards, there will always be a different amount of cards in between them. This is easy to visualize if we place the cards in a ring. You and your friend agree that you will always choose the card with the smallest count between it and the other card, starting from that card and moving in a clockwise direction. There are 1, 2, 3, 4 cards when counting from the queen to the 4, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 cards when counting from the 4 to the queen. So you put the queen of diamonds in your pocket. You can click on the information card in the right-hand corner of the screen to remind yourself which card is in your pocket at any time throughout the video. We'll call this the mystery card, and the 4 remaining cards from the demon's hand, the messenger cards. The messenger cards are the ace of spades, the 10 of hearts, the 4 of diamonds, and the 10 of clubs. You both agree that the card in the first envelope will have the same suit as the mystery card, so you place the 4 of diamonds in envelope number 1. Your friend now knows that the mystery card is from the diamond suit and that one of the repeated cards is the 4 of diamonds. The mystery card can't be any of these cards, because then the 4 of diamonds would have had the smallest count between it and the other card when moving in a clockwise direction, so it would have been selected as the mystery card. This narrows the search down to just 6 cards. You both agree that envelope number 2 means the mystery card is in the lower third of the remaining possible cards. Envelope 3 means it's in the middle third, and envelope 4 means it's in the upper third. The messenger card with the highest value will be used to communicate this information. But which messenger card has the highest value? If we go by card convention, 10 is higher than ace, but there are 2 tens. To get around this, you assign value to the suits. For example, spades is greater than hearts, hearts is greater than diamonds, and diamonds is greater than clubs. This will safely break any ties between card values. Because hearts is greater than clubs, the 10 of hearts has the highest value. You place it in envelope number 2 to tell your friend the mystery card is in the lower third. So now your friend knows the mystery card is either the jack or the queen of diamonds. Continuing this pattern of communication, you both agree that if the card with the next highest value, the 10 of clubs, is placed in the envelope with the lowest value, the mystery card is in the lower half of the remaining 2 possible cards, and if placed in the envelope with the highest value, it's in the upper half. The mystery card is the queen of diamonds. This strategy will work for any hand the demon gives you. If he gives you a hand with 2 repeated suits, it doesn't matter which one you choose. This strategy will work equally well with either one. It even works when there are more than 2 repeated cards in a hand, but I'll leave that up to you to figure out how. This strategy works because once we've narrowed it down to one suit, we have 3 messenger cards and 12 or less possible mystery cards, as there are 13 cards per suit and we know that the other repeated card is not it. There are 3 possible envelopes we can place the second messenger card, 2 envelopes we can place the third messenger card, and 1 envelope we can place the last messenger card. This makes a total of 6 possible arrangements. But because we have 12 possibilities, this isn't enough to get us down to just one card. By choosing the repeated card with the smallest count, we cut the number of possible mystery cards in half. So there are always 6 or less possible mystery cards and 6 ways to arrange the messenger cards, so they will always be able to point to the mystery card. This will work for a set of 52 of anything, it doesn't have to be cards, as long as you devise an appropriate ordering system. So that's it, you're free to go. Looks like this demon will have to spend eternity counting gas particles alone.